The silencer consisted of a sleeve, outside, and a tube, inside, which in all had a diameter of 43.5 millimeters. When the rifle was found next to Robin's body, it contained the five-shot magazine with two bullets still in it and a bullet in the chamber. The scene examination also revealed a live bullet lying near the rifle, and, right next to Robin's right hand, investigators found the 10-shot magazine containing three bullets. The magazine was found upright on its curved, narrowest side. Robin lay almost flat on his back by a beanbag, the rifle pointing towards his left leg, the muzzle of the silencer about 30 centimeters from his body. His feet were pointing towards the door, and he had a few small smears of blood on each hand, more on the left one. He had a number of small, superficial abrasions, mainly on the backs of his hands. The injuries showed drying and rounding of the margins, suggesting they had started to heal. The bullet that killed Robin hit him in the front area of his left temple and went diagonally across his brain about parallel with the floor. Robin was right-handed, so the shot to the left temple, if self-inflicted, was unusual. A 1981 Washington State study reviewing suicides by firearms over 15 years found that where the deceased used a rifle, of the total shots, 51 were to the mouth, 48 to the right temple, 33 to the chest, and the same number to the forehead. 19 were under the chin, 8 to the back of the head, and 7 to the left temple. The study found most individuals held true to their handedness when shooting themselves, but about 8% inflicted their wounds on the other side. About 10% of the population are left-handed. A 2011 study by researchers at the University of Belgrade reviewed 479 firearm suicides between 1999 and 2009, where the deceased had died from one shot to the head.